Okay? You with me? And every tongue that shall rise against you in judgment, you shall condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord. And their righteousness is of me, says the Lord. Now I want you to note that verse 13 promises you you'll have peace. You'll be taught of the Lord. Verse 14 says you'll be in righteousness, established. You're far from oppression. You'll not fear. It won't come near you. Verse 15 says, by the way, they will gather together against you, but God says he will not be the one doing it. And in fact, those that gather against you will fall for your sake. All right? Then verse 16, in the middle of that protection, and even verse 17 again, the no weapon formed against thee prosper, this is your heritage, but yet verse 16, God throws in there, I've created the smith that blows the coal in the fire, brings forth an instrument for his work, and I've created the waster to destroy. Now, guys, because of my upbringing, because of misunderstanding for many years, I always thought that meant the devil. God created the devil to destroy. But that doesn't make sense, because God is a good God. He's not out here trying to create the devil to destroy people or things. He's promised in verse 13, 14, 15, and 17 your divine protection, and this is your heritage. This is what you've inherited. So why would he put in verse 16 that he's created the devil to destroy you? Because he hasn't. Now, here's what he has done. He has created a group of people, a body of Christ, with authority to destroy the works of the devil. Hallelujah. So he here is the one who's created the smith that blows coal fire. In other words, he has fanned the flames of the body of Christ to go do the work of God, and he has created a waster to destroy. Now, not the devil here, but in fact, the body of Christ to go out and destroy the works of the devil publicly and victoriously. Now, if you don't understand that, look with me, if you would, to 1 John chapter 3, and I'll tie that together. But you see how people can take that and twist it, and they read it, and then they deny God's power or put his power in the wrong place, attributed to the devil. 1 John chapter 3, is that what I said? Mm-hmm. And verse 8, somebody read verse 8 for me.
But when people keep on sinning, it shows that they belong to the devil, who has been sinning since the beginning. But the Son of God came to destroy the works of the devil.
The Son of God came to what?
Destroy.
Destroy. Here we go, Isaiah 54 and verse 16. He has created the waster to destroy. It depends upon how you see God. He is the defeater of evil, not the causer of it. He has created the body of Christ, the authority of the body of Christ, to destroy the works of the devil in our lives. That's good news, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So, we're not a people that denies God's power. We're not a people that gives the devil credit. God credit for the devil's works. We place it in truth, and that is, we say, devil, you are defeated. God, you are a good God. This is my heritage. I am free. No weapon formed against me can prosper anymore. No dream that comes at me can get a foothold in my life, an evil dream that is. No sickness or disease can overcome me anymore. These things are defeated because God has given me the authority to destroy the works of the devil. Obviously, I have to recognize the works before I want to destroy them. If I think it's part of him, I accept it. You know what I mean? You okay with that, guys?
Amen.
All right. Praise the Lord.